Welcome to this mini project where you're going to get some experience working with Amazon Macie. And Macie is a machine learning based service which can automatically evaluate any data that you have stored in S3 and identify and take action based on any sensitive data stored within S3. Now, in order to complete this mini project, as always, make sure that you're logged into an AWS account using an identity with admin permissions. If you're using any of my courses, then you can use the I am admin user in the general AWS account, so that's the management account of the organization. If you're not using my courses, then just make sure that you're logged in with an identity which has admin permissions. Now, this mini project should work in most AWS regions. You should make sure that you're just using the same region throughout, and of course it would be my strong recommendation to use the Northern Virginia or US-East-1 region. That's the region I'm going to be using, and this mini project has been thoroughly tested in that region. Now, attached to this lesson is a full set of text-based instructions, and importantly, it also has some sample data that we're going to be using as part of this mini project. So specifically, there's data for a CC or credit card .txt, employee information, so employees.txt, access credentials, so keys.txt, and then some custom data for license plates of Australian vehicles, and that's going to be stored in plates.txt. So what I recommend is go to these text-based instructions and just at the top, copy and paste all of that data into the correct file names, because you'll be using those throughout this mini project. Now, to get started, we need to move across to the S3 console. So type S3 in the search box at the top and then open that in a new tab. We're going to be creating a new bucket, so go ahead and click on Create Bucket. We'll use the name mixed-data, but I want you to prefix this with your initials and then add a suffix at the end of a random number. So in my case, AC-mixed-data-1337. And then just make sure for the region, you pick the same region that you're operating in, which is US-East-1. Once you've done that, you can scroll all the way down to the bottom and click on Create Bucket. Now, once you've done that, I want you to go inside the bucket and then click on Upload and then Add Files. And we're going to add all of those files that you've just created into that bucket. So in my case, I'm going to add all four of those files, and all of these contain sensitive data. So I'll click on Open, scroll down and click on Upload. Once I've done that, I'm also going to add some other data. I'm going to add Bunny the cat. So this is an image of Bunny the cat, and clearly she is the most fluffy cat in the world. That's just some non-sensitive data to go along with our sensitive data in those text files. So once you've got all of those five objects in the bucket, we're good to move on to the next step. And to do that, click in the search box at the top and type Macie, and then open that in a new tab. So once again, Macie is a machine learning service, and it's going to be configured to identify any sensitive data in our bucket. And this same process could be applied across all of the buckets of your organization. Now, if you haven't used Macie before, we need to enable it. So to do that, click on Get Started, and then click on Enable Macie. Now go ahead and wait until you see a console screen like this, and then we're good to proceed to the next step. What we need to do next is create a job for our S3 bucket. We need to tell Macie to begin analysing objects within our S3 bucket. So to do that, go ahead and click on S3 buckets, and then check the box next to the bucket that you've created. In my case, AC-mixed-data-1337. And once you've selected that bucket, click on Create Job. Then click on Next. We don't need to set anything on this page. This is going to be a one-time job. You can configure Macie to run regularly, but for this mini project, we're just going to do it the once. So select one-time job, and then click on Next. Now at this point, you're able to select the Managed Data Identifier options. Now, a Managed Data Identifier, as this screen suggests, it's a set of criteria that detects a specific type of sensitive data. Now, you can create your own custom data identifiers, and on this screen, you have the option of selecting all. You can check everything but a set that you exclude, or you can check only the set that you include, or check none. Now, for this mini project, we're going to use all, so make sure all is selected and then click on next. Now, at this point in the mini project, we're not going to be adding any custom data identifiers, but we are going to be doing that later on in the mini project. We're going to use it to detect vehicle license plates with an Australian format, but we'll do that later on. For now, just go ahead and click on next. We won't be setting any allow lists, so click on next again. For job name, you can enter anything you want. You could put risky data or scary data or something that you choose. Just go ahead and enter a job name and then scroll down and click on next. And then you're given one last opportunity to review all of the job configuration. Everything looks good. Scroll down to the bottom and click submit. Now, this can take up to 20 minutes to complete, so you need to go ahead and pause the video, wait for the status of this job to change to complete, and once it has, then you're good to resume the video. Welcome back, and now that the job's complete, we can go ahead and click on Show Results, and then in the drop-down, put Show Findings. You'll be able to see the type of sensitive data that's been identified by Macie. In this case, we have personal data, credentials, and credit card information, and all of these have been identified together with the resources that are affected. So we can see here we've got employee data, we've got some keys or credentials stored in this object, and we've got credit card information in the bottom object. Now, just as a reminder, if we look at one of these text files, so let's open one in our code editor, this is an example of the employees.txt object. So this is the type of data that we have stored within these objects, and this has been identified by Macie as potentially sensitive. And likewise, we've got data in these other files. We've got keys.txt and then cc.txt, which contains credit card information. Now, note that it didn't identify this plates.txt as sensitive. And this is because these vehicle license plates are in an Australian-specific format. And we need to configure Macie specifically to identify these. And that's one of the things we're going to do next. Before we do that though, let's go ahead and move back to the AWS console and we're going to configure some notifications so that Macie can notify us when any sensitive data is identified. So click in the search box at the top and type SNS and then right click on Simple Notification Service and open that in a new tab. Then go to that tab, click on Topics and create a topic. It's going to be a standard topic. And for topic name, go ahead and type Macie-alerts. Then scroll down and expand access policy. Leave the method on basic, but we're going to configure this account so it can be a publisher and a subscriber. So click in the publishers dropdown, and then click on only the specified AWS accounts. Then click the dropdown at the top right. Click to copy your account ID. Paste it into the publisher account ID box. Then under subscribers, click. Again, only the specified AWS accounts. And paste in your account ID again. Then scroll down and click on Create Topic. Then we need to configure you as a subscriber. So click on subscribers and then create subscription. In the protocol dropdown, click and select email, and then enter your email address in this box. I'm going to enter mine, but you need to enter your email address. Then scroll down and create subscription. Now you're going to receive an email, and this will contain a link to approve this subscription. So go ahead and click that link, and once you've done so, if you click on the topic name at the top, so Macie Alerts, the status should change to confirmed. And that means we're good to continue. Next, we're going to use Event Bridge so that we're notified whenever Macie has any findings. So click in the search box at the top, type Event, and then right-click on Amazon Event Bridge and open that in a new tab, and then move to that tab. We're going to create an event bridge rule, so make sure the event bridge rule option is selected and then click on create rule. For the rule name, go ahead and use Macie-events, and it's going to be a rule with an event pattern. And as well, just make sure that this rule is enabled. So make sure the toggle is enabled for this specific rule. And then click on Next. It's going to be an AWS event or an EventBridge partner event, so make sure that option is selected. And then scroll down past the sample event dialog. And then for method, make sure that use pattern form is selected. Make sure event source is set to AWS services. And then in the AWS service dropdown, click type Macie and then click on Macie. For the event type, select Macie finding. So we want this rule to trigger whenever Macie identifies any sensitive data. Once you've done that, go ahead and click on Next. For the targets, it's going to be an AWS service, so make sure that's selected, then click in the Select a Target dropdown, type SNS, and then click SNS topic. Pick the topic you created in the previous step, so Macie-alerts, click Next, Next again, then scroll down and create the rule. So this means whenever Macie identifies any sensitive data, this EventBridge rule will be triggered and it will send that event through to SNS and you'll be notified. Now next, we're going to add a custom identifier so that Macie's capable of identifying vehicle license plates in an Australian format. So go back to the Macie console, you should still have it open in a tab. Then on the menu on the left, under Settings, click Custom Data Identifiers, and then click on Create. For the name, type License Plates with an uppercase L and P, and then in the instructions attached for this lesson, there's a regular expression which you can copy and paste which will identify Australian license plates. So go ahead and copy that regular expression and then paste it in to the regular expression box. Once you've done that, scroll down and click Submit. Now using this custom data identifier, it means that Macie will now be capable of identifying any Australian license plates. And to configure that, we need to configure a job. So click on S3 buckets and select the S3 bucket containing your data and then click on Create Job. Then click Next. It's going to be a one-time job again, so select that option. Then click Next. Leave Managed Data Identifiers set to All and click on Next. Then under Custom Data Identifiers, select License Plates. And this is the custom identifier that you just created. So select that and click on Next. We won't be setting any allow lists, so click on Next again. For job name, type License Plates. Click Next. We can review this and then click Submit. Now again, this will take some time to complete. You will receive some email notifications while this job is in progress, but pause the video and wait for the status to change to complete, and then we're good to continue. Okay, at this point the job has finished. You should have received some JSON formatted notifications to your email, and that's okay, they were just for illustration purposes. But this job has completed, so if we click on Show Results and then Show Findings, we can see that it's now identified another medium severity set of findings, and these are within our plates.txt file. So this is the object which contains our Australian formatted vehicle license plates. And you can create custom data identifiers which identify any business-specific or region-specific sensitive data that you want Macie to be able to identify. And when you do that, you can either perform ad hoc one-off jobs or you can configure regular jobs and then have EventBridge set up to perform other tasks such as automated notification or automated remediation when those findings occur. And that's a really powerful form of event-driven security within AWS. Now at this point, that is everything I wanted to cover in this mini project. The only thing which remains is to tidy up the account and return it into the same state as it was at the start of this mini project. To do that, we need to move back to SNS, select the topic that you created, click Delete, and then confirm that deletion. Then go to Subscriptions and delete any subscriptions that you created for this mini project. Then go to Macie. Then click on Settings. And if you did enable Macie specifically for this mini project, then you can go ahead and click this button to disable Macie. You'll need to confirm that by typing disable and then clicking to disable Macie. If it was already enabled, then you'll need to make the decision yourself whether to disable it or not. Then we need to move to the Event Bridge console, click on Rules, select the Macie Events rule, and click Delete, and then confirm that deletion, then move back to S3, go to Buckets, select the bucket that you created, click on Empty, and confirm that empty process, and then once done, select it again, click Delete, and confirm that deletion. And at this point, the account is back in the same state as it was at the start of this mini project. So I hope this has been a fun and useful mini project. It has been fairly simple, but the techniques and skills that you've learned can be applied to much larger production projects. At this point, though, you can go ahead and complete the video, and I hope you'll join me soon in another exciting mini project.